We have some goals that we need to set for Alex and Emma, y'all. Get a driver's ed, pass the test, get the license, because you guys need to drive to school the first day. Baby. Get down. My new job for the last year has been car salesman. Some people say it sales consultant, car sales representative. I'm old-fashioned. I'm a car salesman. Being a little person as a car salesman, I'm going to always look at the advantage side of it. People are going to always remember me versus other people. And your size doesn't matter. Your personality does, so you know where my desk is. Yeah.
Yes, I do.
It's right there.
Yeah, we have to
look because
first.
There's a big family portrait of us. I know it's our desk.
With Alex and Emma growing up and starting their junior year, they are about to get their driver's license. Since we start driving, it'll be time to pick out a car for them. We'll pick a hotter, brighter day next time.
Yeah.
We'll look at the little red Bronco first.
Okay.
Who else is in the driver's seat?
Me.
Okay.
I'll see.
You like the color?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I like
it's
the red. It's pretty nice.
Yeah, it is pretty nice.
It's right about like our feet hitting the dashboard, yeah. Like you said.
When we have customers come onto our lot, not everybody's the same size, and they're worried about driving. Well, that car is too big. I'm not going to be able to drive it. And I said, no, you can. I drive a full-size truck, and look at me, and you're a lot taller than I am. So when I show them the different ways that we can make things work to fit an individual for this car, you know, that's a selling point. See, this part right here doesn't go down.
Mm.
So, like, it don't tilt down to let your legs be lower. So the only other way would be...
farther back.
All right, now sit up some. All right, now you see how your feet are more clear? Your feet are not sticking straight up, hitting the bottom of the steering column.
Yeah.
But you'd have to have,
a
cushion behind them. And I'm really against cushions. When we think about 16-year-old kids driving cars for the first time, we all think about the average-sized teenage boy or girl. And they can pretty much get in the car, adjust the mirrors, slide the seat forward a little bit, and that's it. The cars are made for them. The cars are not made for us. As we've always said, anything that we do in our life, we do differently. Get your hand out of there. All right. You can do it. Pull it down.
There was nothing worse than after you loaded up all them kids, you hooked it, you pulled it down.
All right, now, Alex, you come hold it for her.
All right, you're good.
Now, you jump out, Emma.
You were doing like this, and bam.
Hit your head, yeah.
Yeah, then you get in the van, and you are 10 shades past.
Let's look at this. It's quite a bit smaller. This one's power seats, ooh. And it's leather.
This feels very restricted. Like, I don't have a good range of motion here. My dream car is a Tesla Model S Plaid.
When you get one, can I drive it?
No.
Oh.
Over my dead body.
Oh. My dream car is a 4Runner. They look badass, and that's what I am.
I have many, but one of my dream cars would be a 95 BMW. Any of the M series, but the 95.
A hot pink Beetle.
Okay, Barbie.
So look, I want to show you something about this one. I'll hop out and I'll show you. All right, here's the hatch on this one. Now open this hatch.
Where's the hatch at?
It's not on the remote.
It's not?
It's not.
Keep looking.
For some reason, like, the hatch wouldn't open. Like, there was no button or anything. So I was, like, confused.
No, there's the light.
Wave your foot.
No, there's nothing. How do you open the trunk?
I don't think Dad was being very helpful while we were trying to figure this car hatch out.
This is why Mom's going to like this one, too.
Oh.
What? Oh, my
gosh.
That's
nice.
It's, like, a lot easier.
It's very LP-friendly.
I think he was trying to let us figure it out before he did it for us.
Well, we don't have a license.
I say we drive the white one.
Okay.
Let's do it.
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
All right, let me go get the pedals. Most little people drive with pedal extensions.
Ooh, hot.
They bolt on to the manufacturer's car pedals, and then there's a piece of threaded rod that extends, and it will increase or decrease the different heights.
Oh, man, I don't want to do this too many more times.
You all ready?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is awesome.
But overall, it rides pretty good.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it rides pretty smooth.
It's got a great radio system.
Nice.
Speakers throughout. You can pair your phone with it. So it does have navigation.
Oh,
right,
nice.
There's navigation.
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool.
During the test drive, it really felt like Dad was trying to turn on his salesman charm. It was unfortunately working on me because I started to really like this car.
It's gonna be easy to park. It has a backup camera.
Parallel parking is what I'm really concerned with.
Me too.
And if you get a boyfriend or girlfriend and you're on a date, look, it's small enough you can reach and hold her hand.
I still have a while, Dad.
You're 16, you're allowed to date?
I'm 16, I mean, I still have a lot more things going on right now.
Okay.
Maybe he doesn't want one.
I just want the time for one right now. That sounds wrong, but I have other things in my life I need to handle first before I get a girlfriend.
Dating? I don't want to talk about it.
That was a
nice
test drive.
Nice car, yeah.
You like it?
Yeah,
yes,
yeah, it rides
like
really
it.
Smooth.
We need a car that we know we've done everything that we can to make this car accessible and they can reach. Let's grab the key and go inside and see what kind of numbers Dad can come up with.
Okay.
There's no purchasing today. We're,
yeah,
of course, we came
we're
to look
looking.
Today. It almost fits in like a glove. When Anna, Joan, and Elizabeth got cars, we stayed around that $5,000 to $6,000 price range for their first car. And right now in this market, there ain't no $6,000 cars out there. Across the nation, there is a car shortage. With new car inventory being very limited, it has drastically raised the price of used cars. So again, how old is this car?
2017.
5 years old.
5 years old, yeah.
It already has 86,000 miles, and it's $33,000.
Wow, the prices of the cars are a lot.
I knew this car was in stock and it was available for purchase. And I told Amber about it just 2 nights ago and said, this is a really nice car. And everything that it does will fit them. Well, this is what I was showing them. We can't find low-priced vehicles right now that don't have a million miles and they're not wore out.
Well, why don't we tell them?
What?
Dad and I went ahead and bought it.
Oh.
Oh.
And our parents surprised us with
a new car.
Woo!
The fact that Trent and I can provide them with a car, it's amazing.
We're so lucky to have Mom and Dad. They make sure that we have everything we need, and like, I just don't know what I'd do without them.
All right.
All right.
I knew they'd like it. The back door was the best part, though.